make a start, shall we? I haven't played this since the demo, so I'm looking forward to this one. Let's give it a go. The end is never. The end is loading. Vlad, hello. Nice to meet you. Hello, welcome to the stream. Today we are going to be playing two games. Ah, good. Twitch is caught up. That's nice.
This is the story of a man named Stanley. Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427. Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427 and he pushed buttons on a keyboard. Orders came to him through a monitor on his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order. This is what employee 427 did every day of every month of every year. And although others might have considered it soul-rending, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in, as though he had been made exactly for this job. And Stanley was happy. And then one day, something very peculiar happened. Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget.
He grew a second head.
He had been at his desk for nearly an hour when he realized that not one single order had arrived on the monitor for him to follow. No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi. Never in all his years at the company had this happened, this complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses, he got up from his desk and stepped out of his office.
Oh, graphically this is so totally different from the old version I've got. If we got a bit of time later on, I'll show you that one, just to see how much it's evolved. And hello, KingCrawler1. Okay, let's gird our loins and step through the door. Yeah, that reminds me of my old job as well. Oh, scary.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
And he decided he's going to try a lot of doors first, just to see what happens. No. This is not a real office. There's no outline of a bottom in the photocopier.
No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
That was turned on. Now it's not. There's his job's a YouTuber. What does he need a soul for?
Stanley went around touching every little thing in the office, but it
Door
didn't make
four,
a
three,
single
seven,
difference.
Five times.
Nor
why the hell not?
Did it advance the story in any way?
Oh, gotta find it first. Ah, there it is. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Bored now. Oh, nothing else happening here. Let's move on. That one's on as well. What a waste of electricity. Looks like he's surfing porn as well. Terrible. Yep, this is a corporate office, isn't it? Very few things are as soulless. Username access. That's a funny username. Nope, nothing there. Okay. Try this one. 438. Did we just do that one? No, we did 437. Okay, let's see if we can go back and find 438. No, I can't find it. There's a 428. Let's try that a few times. Ah, that's all boring. Okay. Well, I'm hoping there's many funny achievements, otherwise this evening is going to be a bit boring. No 438s here. Nope. Okay. Onwards, 417. No. Let me in. I want to go in. Oh no, you're not buffering, are you? Oh dear. I'm very sorry about that. According to my diagnostic software, everything is being sent okay and I'm not losing any packets. 430. Let's see if we can find a 430. Yes. Find a 430. 430. Oh dear. Where are you? There it is. Right. 1, 2, 3.
Oh please.
4. There
we go.
Are
you really just doing this for the achievement? Click a door 5 times. Is that all that you think an achievement is worth? No, 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 no. I can't just give these merits away for such little effort. A measly 5 clicks. Now suppose you were to click the door 20 times. I would say that's the kind of effort that warrants recognition.
Well, I don't know about you, but that seems to me to be a challenge. Look at me, I'm a door-clicking fool. And I've lost count.
I have to say, I'm still not feeling the satisfaction of witnessing true effort for a noble cause. Perhaps 50 clicks will do it. Yes, almost certainly.
Right.
50 clicks.
Okay. 21. 22. 23. 24. Halfway there. 26. 27. 28. 3. 29. 30. 31. 32. 33. 34. 35, 36, 7, 38, 39, 40,
no,
41.
No, I'm still not feeling it. I want this achievement to have meant something. It has to be a true reward for valiant effort. I want to see some hustle, Stanley. I want to see commitment, a willingness to go all the way, no matter what the cost. Why don't you go put 20 clicks into door number 417?
I will win this. 417. 417. Oh, I remember. There's one back here. Come on. Come on. There it is. Right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Ooh, great. Now, go click a few times on door 437.
Oh, dear. And the parable is a story with a lesson to be learned from the end of it. The only lesson that can be learned from my life is don't.
Excellent. I think we're getting somewhere. Now, door 415. Let's give it 10 clicks or so.
Oh, dear. 415. Through here. No, that's 417. 416. 415. The door of destiny itself. Seven.
Now, back to door number 437.
437, charge! There we go.
Let's see. How about you click on, well, I don't know, the copy machine.
The copy machine.
All right. Back to room 417. I'm really feeling it now. I think we're getting somewhere.
Okay. 415, 416. We've gone past it. 417. Here we go.
Okay. Now go climb on employee 419's desk.
419, 419? Whatever that is. Out of cheese error, perhaps. Can we jump? We can't jump.
Okay. Yes! This is great! You're putting it all on the line, Stanley. I like that. All right, let's keep it up. Go give me a few clicks on door 416.
416, charge!
We've almost got it! Now the copy machine, do that one again!
Oh dear, somebody's going to need to change trousers at this rate. Copy machine, where are you? Hello, Sapphire 2300, just in time.
Finish it off, Stanley! 5 clicks on door 430!
430, where's that one again? There it is. 1, 2, 3.
Yes! We did it! Oh, wow. That felt amazing. Oh, you really earned it, Stanley. Nothing could hold you back. Yes, I'm very proud of how far we've come today. Just think, only a few minutes ago, you believed an achievement was worth 5 little clicks. Really now, what were you thinking?
I've got to be honest with you, he has got a wonderful voice, hasn't he? Okay, let's move on and see where things take us now. Is any of these screens turned on? No, time to move. Time to step out of our comfort zone. Time to go forth and look at other grey doors.
When Stanley came to a set of 2 open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Okay, guys, left or right? You tell me. Yes, but he definitely needed a cigarette afterwards. You're absolutely right. Chrissy Toff, hello. Just in time. Left or right? So, that's 3 rights, 1 left, and a meh. 4 rights, 5 rights. Okay, we're going right. Which should please the guy who said meh as well. Who said meh? Same difference. Sapphire. Okay,
this was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
We'll do the broom cupboard one afterwards. Because I'm sure we're going to be going this way again fairly soon. No, I want to turn that one off. Let me in. Okay. All these are boring.
Ah, yes. Truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth the detour after all, just to spend a few moments here in this immaculate, beautifully constructed room. Stanley simply stood here, drinking it all in.
One step down, one massive step backwards from Half-Life 1 to Half-Life 2 was the cold drink dispensers
yes,
have stopped working.
Really, really worth it being here in the room.
Oh, absolutely.
A room so utterly captivating that even though all your co-workers have mysteriously vanished, here you sit looking at these chairs and some paintings. Really worth it.
The objective of this game is to find the endings. There are loads and loads of endings depending on the decisions you make
at
through the game.
At this point, Stanley's obsession with this room bordered on creepy and reflected poorly on his overall personality. It's possible that this is why everyone left.
The time. 20 to 12. Almost dinner time. Right, let's head on.
Stanley sat around waiting for more dialogue. But when a long time had passed and there was no more, he decided that the game was trying to send him a message. But at last, he'd had enough of the amazing room and took the first open door on his left to get back to business.
First open door. Okay, do we rejoin the path or do we carry on? I'm saying let's carry on this time. Nothing there.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago.
Okay, right, let's... Drafting tables. We've gone from little offices where you press buttons to drafting tables to a large warehouse. Interesting. Interesting. And the doors, they close themselves. Can we get up here? No, we can't jump. Go through this door? Nope. Do not jump from the cargo lift while it is in motion. Will cause death. Penalty for misuse of cargo lift, $1,000. Penalty for jumping off the cargo lift, death.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong
foot.
But in his eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story and no one gets to tell him what to do, Stanley leapt from the platform and plunged to his death. Good job, Stanley. Everyone thinks you are very powerful.
Our first ending. Great. Anything new in here? No.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
This is different. You can't climb on it this time. Becky Boo 152. Hello and welcome aboard the stream. Yes, I'm utterly jealous of that voice actor's tones. He's so good. Waiting inputs. Ah. Alright, I can only put one input in. Okay. Interesting. Alright, I did promise left and into the broom closet. This time.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
There, that should make him happier.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
We need more stroke less reviews. 402 and 405 want to get rid of the death sport portion in the primary review schedule. But I think that's a stupid idea! More water coolers, more water cooler heaters. Charts need to be more hip to appear to the teenage demographic. Find teenagers to put in teenage demographic. Big net? Some sort of child trap, yes. Teenagers, size of demographic, space between the two. Throw something in the ideas bin. Hiring me, nice. The Boss Appreciation Minute. On your Boss Appreciation Minute worksheet, circle the top 20 things you love most about your boss. Fill out in triplicate and return. Yes. Tips not to get fired. Oh, if only I'd read that once. If you ever... okay. Excuse the sniffing, I've still got a bit of a cold. Number three, don't get fired. Good one. To do, synergize core value expenditures. Yep. Welcome to Business Speak. Right, moving on.